longer have to view man as being in a fallen state. You don't need to be forgiven for just being born. We're not born into sin. People are good or bad based on decisions they make and their actions. Actions are more important than beliefs. Atheists look for solutions from inside. We don't ask for a God to step in and help us or others. We change our behavior, our attitude, or our addictions by making the right choice and taking action. Atheists get to make those changes that would never happen with prayer. It takes action. Atheists take responsibility and realize they are in control. When a situation is not within our control, praying is not a solution. Religion teaches comfort with a deferment and a lack of responsibility. For women, atheism is a chance to be free of an oppressive belief system that teaches women that they are second-class citizens of a faith designed by and for men. Atheists can watch movies, listen to music, and read books without worrying about them being pleasing to a god. Atheists can read Harry Potter and study evolution without feeling like the devil is trying to get them.
Mr. Smith, all the evidence shows that you brutally raped Miss Thompson here.
Look, I feel kind of bad about what I did.
Sorry.
Okay, you think you could forgive me?
Forgive you? Hell no, I won't forgive you! I hope you rot in hell for raping me!
Bailiffs, go get my son, Jesse.
Mr. Smith, as my free gift to you, my son Jesse has been punished on your behalf. If you accept this gift, you will not be held accountable for your crime.
What?
Okay, I accept. Thanks, Judge. Thanks, Jesse.
Welcome.
Mr. Smith, I do hereby forgive you for raping Miss Thompson. You are free to go.
I can't believe this!
Oh, you better believe it, Miss Thompson. You better believe it.
Mr. Clark, isn't it true that while you were making love to your wife, Tina, you shouted out the name Jessica? Okay, yes, at the time I was thinking about my high. Honey, I swear I never, ever cheated on you.
Oh, you cheated on her in your heart, Mr. Clark. I'm ready to rule. Bailiffs, bring in my son, Jesse. My son, Jesse, has been punished on your behalf. If you accept this gift, you will not be held accountable for your crime.
What? Judge, this is barbaric. If what I did was so wrong that you feel I need to be punished, then you go ahead and you punish me.
Okay. Bailiffs, burn them.
What? But you didn't burn your son. What are you talking about? What are you doing this for?
Oh, your punishment is going to be a hell of a lot worse than what I did to my son.
No, what are you doing? Just let him go!
No, no, it's too late for that now, Mr. Clark. Oh, by the way, Mr. Clark, remember, I love you.
An experience with
what experience?
My own personal experience.
Okay, what experience?
Jesus Christ. He lives.
Okay, so
he lives, his spirit.
Okay, spirit. So hang on. I used to be a Christian. If Jesus actually exists and loves me and cares for me, why wouldn't he demonstrate himself to me in the same way that he's demonstrated himself to you?
He does. We just don't recognize.
How? Okay. How does he do this?
We choose.
No. How does he demonstrate this?
How does he? Through his Holy Spirit.
Okay. That doesn't tell me anything.
Okay, let me ask you, did you attend the church?
Yes.
What kind of church?
Southern Baptist.
Southern Baptist?
I was also in Pentecostal churches, Church of Christ, a number of different ones.
Okay.
Okay.
Where does the sun come from? Where does the air we breathe come from?
Okay, do you think that this is, I understand this isn't just an opportunity to preach. I'm asking for evidence. Now, please let me finish.
Okay.
So you think...
When you think about the reasoning that we have, right or wrong, that's God there.
And your justification for this is that right and wrong exists?
They would pray that they would...
Can I get a damn sentence out? Your justification for this
is that Jesus said for us to do, pray for them.
Okay, you know what? Until you demonstrate existence, I don't give a damn what Jesus says. Oh, it's just a feeling, or he speaks to me, or right and wrong, or the fact that the sun and everything else exists. No, there's an explanation for why the sun exists, and it's all naturalistic and scientific.
Yeah, Jesus.
Do you like the wine?
Very much. What is it?
Take a guess.
I have to leave.
Nah, sit down.
Know that he is so far and beyond any of our ways that he can work the worst situation for his good.
What was the Holocaust? Why was that good?
You know, God had a plan for that. Maybe it's to cause.
I wonder if you would have thought that if you were one of the people being pushed into an oven.
That's not moral.
And it does say that our God is a jealous God.
But your God is jealous? That seems so ungodlike that God would have such a petty human emotion.
He's also...
I know people who have gotten over jealousy, God.
There's two sides of the coin. He's a just God, and he's also a merciful God. He can't stand our sin, but he also...
No, he spends the first five books of the Bible wiping out people.
Well, that's what he chose to do. His ways are higher than ours, Bill.
Maybe our thinking should be higher.
That's a good point. Well, have you ever had a little small voice in the back of your mind say some things?
Okay. We've all had that.
That's called
the
Holy
not
Spirit.
God, that's you.
That's called the Holy Spirit.
Oh, the Holy Spirit.
Feel this wind right now?
Yeah.
Okay, where is it?
Yeah,
you don't
it's
know,
called
right?
wind.
Okay, that's like the Holy Spirit.
Does it ever bother you that the story of a man who was born of a virgin, was resurrected, your bio was something that was going around the Mediterranean for at least 1,000 years. We've got Krishna, who was in India 1,000 years before Christ. Krishna was a carpenter, born of a virgin, baptized in a river.
Are you saying that was written in history? That was written down in history, is what you're saying?
Absolutely. There's the Persian god Mithras, 600 years before Christ, born December 25th, performed miracles, resurrected on the third day, known as the Lamb, the Way, the Truth, the Light, the Savior, Messiah.
All I know is that I don't go by that hearsay. That's right. I go by the Word of God. I know that's what I believe.
Oh shit, look at that one. They must have spent like $5,000 on all those decorations. Hey Vishnu.
What?
Where are all the decorations for your birthday?
Ha ha, very funny.
No, seriously, where are they? Because I see like every house in America has decorations up for my birthday, but nothing for yours. Maybe they have some in India. Nope, nothing there. Just some guy wiping his ass with his hand.
Ah, but seriously, dude, happy birthday.
And I don't know how you feel about it, but I am getting pretty sick and tired of these fucking church people. I have just about had it with these fucking church people, all of them. You know what I say we ought to do with these churches? Tax them. Tax these motherfuckers. If they're so interested in politics and government policy and public policy, let them pay their admission price like everybody else. Tax them. They were going to get government off our backs. Yeah, but when it comes to abortion, they don't mind government being in a woman's uterus, do they? These people call themselves right-to-lifers. Don't you love that phrase? And don't you love the way these kind of people pervert the English language, right-to-lifers? You realize that most of the right-to-lifers are in favor of the death penalty? Doesn't it strike you as mildly ironic that most of the people who are against abortion are people you wouldn't want to fuck in the first place? Doesn't it strike you as strange? Pro-life. These people aren't pro-life, they're killing doctors. What kind of pro-life is that? What, they'll do anything they can to save a fetus, but if it grows up to be a doctor, they just might have to kill it?
Yeah.